abafani nalaba labala banamhla, they're actually not politicians because these people are just they emerge and then go for campaigning and then get to parliament. They are not politicians. I don't view them as politicians. My disposition was that I represented the poor. And for me, they were the ones who were driving my agenda, who were driving me crazy every morning I woke up. I guess I dislike politics in a way, even though I believe in politics, but I dislike in the sense that bantu laba lapha ngekhathi abakangikhombisi ukuba honest and to have integrity and to have people at heart.
Baba Ndlangamandla, kumakhadi embabane siyabonga kakhulu ukuthi uteka the bridge where really we are trying to be a platform for national conversation in the country. Sicabanga ukuthi it's a role and space lengabe sithethwebo umsakado sithethwebo swazi TV, but no one is doing it, so we are taking it, especially in light of the penetration of the internet in the country and all of that. So siyabonga kakhulu ukuthi uvume kuto khulumisana nathi funa nje ukuqala lapho baba
ka nama ngibonge kuba khona kulo umsakato lomkhulu lamalanga
yey
siye sithandze ama conversations loba nawo nema speakers lehlukene ngingacabange ukuthi thina exactly la pass say something to say.
Hi, no. Kule list yetu nje vele we knew ukuthi you are there. But off air we were just talking ukuthi I mean ngibone nga 2021 ukuthi we have been operating as a country in we've been so closed and yet outside of each other, as a tani, our histories, our roles and everything. Uboneke nga 2021 the way suddenly this is a platform ye kuluma on social media and we were talking so many things. Ubone ukuthi I know as a tani sibanvu, as a tani sliver, as a tani history and everything. So sometimes we underestimate ukuthi we must reintroduce our people guma platforms and what their role have been and what they've done. So bengicela nje briefly Baba Ndlangamandla ukuthi that 21 year old boy or girl who's watching is today may not know Baba Ndlangamandla ukuthi who is Baba Ndlangamandla, where does he come from, just briefly nje.
Yeah, thank you very much. I'm Emmanuel Nkosinathi Ndlangamandla, a name I got after I was born very ill, I'm told, and I could only be given a name after I was on the road to recovery. Otherwise, I was almost dead, according to my parents. And then
premature death. Premature
death. No. I just was born sick.
Okay.
And then they gave me this name, God with us. Osnat. It came about because of that. I was born, of course, 60 odd years. Eshiselweni 1, endzaweni okuthiwa kumavundluthi, the Mkhwakhweni area. We are sad nje thina si tinhloko tethu tibheke phansi silahlekelwe inkosikati yale ngithe emgazini. I pass my condolences to the Mkaze, I mean Bonjangase ne community yakithi yonke yasemkhwakhweni ngekuhamba kwenkosikade.
Yes, in fact, now that you say it, nami nje I must pass my condolences. Mancoba Njangase very close friend of mine, ngivenyalo ukuthi ngimakwakho lushonile. So nami ngiyanivela buhlungu bami basemgazini.
Yes. So I was born there ngakhulela khona ke enang. I'm a married man with children. And then ngihlala la eMbabane, ngisekhaya futhi khona le kumavundluthi. So I have two homes. I have been managing that since I started with my working life in 1987. So I've been moving between home and eMbabane.
Were you always in the NGO sector in Baba Ndlangamandla?
No, I wanted to just to say I studied Kona Lema Sipula, then I moved to Franson Christian High School.
Oh, okay.
And that is the place that made me who I am today.
Mm.
Because I grounding your activism, see Kalala puts him. Because we were prefects. That were not appointed, were elected.
Oh,
so
yes.
We're on our own, and we used to be very rebellious, even as student leaders at the time. And then I moved to Institute of Health Sciences. I did nursing, and then again I sang it at Institute again about Kalanga 83 again. Sahlangana ke ne timbila tithutsa telqoqo.
Hey, it was a terrible year, fella.
That was the year that we crossed paths with Bo Mandla as leaders of students at the time.
Mandla who?
Hlatshwayo.
Oh, okay.
As leaders as basihlanganisa lapho to be on the streets of Mbabane protesting nge governance yelqoqo and we've been since then behaving these ups and downs in terms of our governance in Jekulelive. From 1983, it has always been the ups and downs of society. So I then joined the workforce. I started in government just for, I had a short stint for a year in government. I think that was... in 1987, I was at Stobela Government Hospital, Health Center, and then I moved to Baphalala Southern Red Cross. I actually just got frustrated. I wanted to be in public health. And then okay. Since I didn't, my wishes were not fulfilled, I got frustrated as a young man. Then I moved to Baphalala Southern Red Cross.
Okay.
From 1989. And then around about 1997, then I moved out of Red Cross.
So you've been outside of mainstream government that long?
I really don't even understand the yeah. system because I was hardly a year there. Then I moved out.
Yeah.
And then I then joined Kango in 1999. That was when I joined Kango as a coordinator or a programs a manager, if you like.
But had it just started Kango or Besey Vele, say you were established?
Kango started in 1987.
Okay.
Actually.
Under that's whose where, leadership?
Under Magesara. He started, of course, like all other organizations. On a voluntary basis, she was a volunteer there, and then I think it started officially to emerge as an organization when we were recruited.
Okay,
yes, that's when they got serious funding after being established with the help of Dr. Samuel Hind, who was a minister of health at the time, and of course had a experience working with NGOs as he was at the RFM.
Yes,
and
yes.
He wanted NGOs to participate and collaborate with government very closely.
Yeah.
Under the primary healthcare drive.
Yeah.
Health for all by year 2000. You remember?
Nangkuluma na pegi makubu some time back. Uti, the politicians of today are not the same as the politicians of yesterday. Uti, there was a lot of maturity with the politicians. Aitolo, most of them had come from the era of independent struggle, you're talking about Hayindi and the relationship he wanted to foster between civil society or NGOs with Nang. Would you agree with Peggy Makubu, Uti, the relationship between government and civil society uma politicians I told was different to the Banyalo? What would be your comment around that with that experience about behind you're talking about?
It's very different.
Yeah.
If you look at how Bobabe Athakoza, Bobabe Heshane, way back, Gubo, Dr. Nomalo, they were different politicians. They came from rigorous politics.
Mm.
So abafani nalabala banamhla, they're actually not politicians, because these people are just they emerge and then go for campaigning and then get to parliament. They are not politicians. I don't view them as politicians.
Mm.
I view them as just part of community representatives that go to parliament, but they're not politicians at all in my scheme of things, except for a few that have stayed, like Bomawe, who have been there for a longer time. They don't even I mean, if you have not been groomed in student politics, for example,
politics,
and many other things of that nature, where do you get your political life?
That's true.
And
that's
understanding. True. So very, they are very different. They are not politicians. We call them politicians because of lack of a better word. Otherwise, they are just people's representatives.
Yeah.
Not politicians at all.
Yeah.
So how have you been
managing to but hey, I can imagine now, Kango, you must manage a very delicate space. On the one hand, Pela, you represent civil society, everyone, and the aspirations of civil society sometimes is in conflict in Nahulumende. At the same time, also, you have to be working closely in Nahulumende. You seem to have managed to do that role with finesse, in my understanding, and the ability to remain neutral, but also be stinging a bit, Nahulumende. Some of us would have failed.
it was a very delicate balance that I had to keep.
Yeah.
To the point, would say, there were times when I felt I was never understood in my sector. I was never understood by government.
Exactly, I would imagine.
but what I had personally understood and appreciated as a professional, it was that you build relationships with human beings, fellow human beings.
Mm.
Once you establish a relationship with a human being, it doesn't matter the differences in your political opinion and otherwise.
Mm.
You are Swazis, you can find each other.
Mm.
Once you find each other, you are able to navigate even delicate situations.
Mm.
So I had to understand because my disposition was that I represented the poor, and for me, they were the ones who were driving my agenda, were driving me crazy every morning I woke up.
Exactly,
it was thinking about the poor because I come from that background myself, and then I was angry at poverty. Because it really nearly ruined my life. Had I not been assisted by teachers, by a lady in England who donated through Save the Children, I would not be anywhere.
Exactly.
Government would not have benefited from my taxes all these years. Because I was just going to be a brain under the bridge. But then I had to establish these relationships. I separated the officials, like the principal secretaries, the directors, and others. I knew these were not politicians. And I always reminded them often that we are together. If we raise issues, it is for your advantage. It's not because we hate government. It's because politicians are different. They are only there for 5 years, and they move on. So I really had to work nabobonge nabantu with the understanding, because even in the progressive movement, sometimes they never understood me.
Exactly, exactly.
They will say, "Oh, this man is sleeping with government." And government will not understand me because they say, "We see him in the progressive camp." But I told them that because I represent the poor, I have to influence the progressives. I have to influence you as government. I don't have to compromise when it comes to matters of the poor.
Exactly.
And that is how I viewed my job every day. I woke up and went to that office.
But there's one thing that I am reminded of. In your era, especially post-1996, right up to 2006, thereabout, that was the era of opportunistic politics, where anyone with constituencies, anyone with power was cajoling himself or herself to be noticed by the powers that be. Bubabe Themba Msiki moved from Labour into NAM. Makakula in.
Yeah,
there are many of them who eventually joined government.
Yeah.
Many.
Yeah.
And I wonder, why didn't you not want to join the gravy train and still kept yourself in that confine?
I guess I dislike politics in a way, even though I believe in politics, but I dislike in the sense that bantu labalapha ngekhatsi abakangikhombisi ukuba honest and to have integrity and to have people at heart. Because that has been, you know, the crux of what really make me wake up every morning. It is to fight for survival of the common man. And then we had to contend with that kind of situation. So I was never attracted to the system, not at all. And I have never been attracted at all. Ikomuti yami ngicela nenga. I remember nakangena njani kulo mnyaka lo. I really had a battle within myself, to the point that I went out of my way to do some mini research. Yes, I went to Parliament. I looked at the Hansard. I talked to Kwakusenabo Nontlanhla at the time in Parliament. I discussed
Makakwaswaka.
Yes. Went under Parliament and exactly. All. How would I? Because it basically yami lange cards. Kwakukuthi, I don't want to get rich and my people
are poor.
So why would I sell them a dummy? When I know for sure, ukuthi lena ngidawufike nginikele linye page lokusebenza.
Eish, uyayithinza leyo Baba Ndlangamandla, and it's quite painful because last year we all went into Parliament. Sathenjiswa nokuthi there will be grand miracles. We were going to fight and push for change and all of that. Hasn't it not surprised you that after so many years of the same model, same thing, same politics, we were still back debating whether or not Parliament can change anything in this country?
I think it's a game. I take it as a game of because the greatest tragedy that has happened in this country is the politics of individualism. I'm contending about that. I'm still trying to read and explore, because really, how do you work and achieve anything? You are an individual. You go to Parliament as an individual, totally detached from your people, because these people, there is no form of accountability. Community is not a party.
Exactly.
It's a group of diverse people, old, young, educated, non-educated, disabled, LGBTI community. So they are so diverse that you, once you are elected, it's just a ticket for you to eat, really. It's a ticket for you to get better, not for the community. Look at how they increase their packs every turn, you know. Now they are telling us, Emabandla this, you know, Parliament gets this and that. It's all about
you as an individual.
As an individual, get better, get ahead.
But why is it that in civil society, we're always having this conversation year in and year out? I can tell you now, next elections, there will be people who will be campaigning on the ticket of saying, why has I am going to make changes in Parliament? I am going to fight for the people, even within civil society. So I'm just curious, Gogutsi, why is it that we are unable to get over this?
It's human nature. It's self-preservation, if you like it. Human beings, njengoba ngisho ukuthi umuntu ubuka bunguye. Some of them are honestly believing they can do something.
Oh, yeah.
They honestly believe they can do something. But in reality, as an individual, because why are we not coalescing together as Shisolan MPs, form a formidable force? We would say, Sinabe Shisolan, we're going to push common agenda to our region. Why? Because of the divide and rule. Once we are there, you get promised. Ungahlube nguminister. Ungahlube ngulok. Ungahlube, you know, that committee. Ungahlube travele. Ungahlube wende. So, because of this self-preservation mentality, I must really save my interests more than anything. And another factor for me, civil society and political parties combined, we are not honest in dealing with this question. Why do we wait until election time?
Yes.
Because in Minangbeng corner, I have been part of, you know, the debates. I feel we never debated sufficiently. We never converse each other honestly and sufficiently. We just rehashed So we also are not honest, because mina ngicabanga ukuthi if we want to deal with this question, we need to bring scholars, we need to bring political scientists, we need to bring experts,
including members of parliament as well, who can tell you that
people, we need people who are going to go and look at how this parliament operates, how my rules, as most of us, whatever they call it, the rules of Basabenda. So, sicubungele yonke lento and have a common understanding, so that when we arrive at a point, we know what it's all about.
But wouldn't someone argue, look, I agree with you that you are whatever, if so, what the politician, expert and scholar say, negate a report. Yes, I agree with everything you've said. That system is watertight in terms of. What will I do outside? What's the alternative?
Lena, you must be clear. You are going there for yourself. Nothing for the people. Forget about the people. If there was something for the people, if I was in parliament, I was going to walk out when Bokoko Banga Kuliselu man. I was going to walk out of the parliament. At least Gupalo Kansa to Singapuma. I cannot continue to debate this budget. Bange Kobo Koko, who were very central. Nakuleku campaignwa ukunyonza bebogogo, the issue yabogogo ibe very central. Nasikhuluma ngesibaya ngoba lesibaya naso is very selective. Bakhetha liphele masini when they choose what they like. No siyakichima nkwe kepha uyabuka kokuthi yini abayiselectayo, baselecta abakufunako. Bogogo should have been the first priority line. Like udlene nasekuphakelwa kule ngwembe. At least 100 emalangeni. You can't even put 1 rand. It's a national shame. We can hang and in we've got shame a as a country. And we've got a parliament that can, no one has raised a finger kule ya parliament le bayiphasile budget. But our passive budget, which is not in line with our aspirations. Bantwana namhla they are hungry in schools. As I speak now, children are hungry in schools. So bani la band. All they are there who pass out the mal temabandla, kuthi bantu abakhuliselwe netabo bephalamende. Where are the people? That's my problem. That's my problem.
That's very true. But without ke lomunye we've just gone Maswazi leaks you may have seen right now, which has shown that we are literally a mafia state, clearly. You will never hear parliament talking about this. They're talking about the vulnerability of the banking system, of our laws and everything. Tell me one parliament who's going to say, Minister of Finance.
Under the current political system, even for post-2021, this parliament, this is going to be the worst parliament, I predict, than we've ever had. Because the parliament should be conformist.
These are not politicians in the sense of old. But laba sebale system.
The ultimate failure of a campaign. It tells you a very strong message. We would say the people that are there, are for the status quo and not for people, really. They will not raise this issue that are fundamental to this country.
Without ke lomunye ke Babe Ndlangamandla, let also be honest. Sithethe thina sima progressives bantu abangayi parliament.
Yeah.
And they abangayi likhetfen. And they went in record numbers. Yeah. And by the way, these are people who have just seen the response and the arrogance of the authorities post 2021. They have seen the but these same people, you would have thought, but out in this time around, but slowly see cocktail while in Vonyalo, say, Bone live, we could live a little dating. But they still went in record numbers. But even more, no matter, it's okay, maybe they don't believe in boycott. Now, Bagay Batige Manje, Fagantin is Matlan de Las Down, Gene Parlamente, and we fight. Still, they never voted for you as a progress. What does it say to someone who like Sadak, Lola Lela le issue about Swaziland and is trying to make sense from both sides? Uthi Hulumende, these guys don't have influence. They are not really being supported. Nange man tinombolo ticho kanjalo.
Unfortunately, numbers numbers game is what works in politics.
Yeah,
that is an unfortunate part. But if they are honest, Nalabo Satak and everyone else, they must look at the environment. No opportunity for civic education from the alternative. Labantu labathi boycott, they can only talk on social media. They have no capacity to go on the ground and mobilize society.
Mm-hmm.
They cannot run a meaningful campaign on the ground. Firstly, the donors are not there to assist in this regard. So vele labantu beva one voice kutsi hambani niyo vota. There's only one stream, one voice.
But wouldn't someone then say, but then why do you call it a struggle, Pela? Because you don't struggle under conditions of your choosing. So uma ngabe utsweno you are in a struggle, then there is no regime that is going to allow you the free space you campaign against me. So obviously they will clamp down. Without Tigolomunye, if Swazis were really interested in change, they would go out of their way and do what in Palestine are doing, what they did in Burkina Faso, what they did in Egypt and everything. Why Lamaswati angagwendile lesikubonile bakwenda kulamanye ama countries?
Yeah, the environment is different. Swaziland is a very small country, you see. And unfortunately, we are also sitting with 60% poor in this country. We have a very low middle class.
Mm-hmm.
And sesi bana lenye phela I downside here too. We have a middle class that is under this ban of self-preservation.
Hey,
as long as they are not suffering themselves, they cannot. Because as you say, why don't we collect money for ourselves? Kube tsina middle class, we are the ones who are running this struggle. In many countries, it is the diaspora, it is the Zimbabwe, it is the people that bafunda bo MTC, bafunda bo CCC and others. They mobilize resources from the people themselves. Tsine la, in middle class, as long as we are comfortable, buku mfatu wako, buku abantu wako, buku alkala wako, we are comfortable. You don't care about the struggle. But as the country goes down, they will feel the pinch, because middle class,
yes.
But the greatest traitors of our time,
I agree.
Including the generation of 1973.
Including the diaspora.
I still blame those in 1973. Why didn't they go to the streets?
But you are being opportunistic when you're blaming us. You had the king kill you. He exiled your leaders, he jailed your leaders, but why have you not risen? Nine the generation ya contemporary sangisho ukuthi ati defend lo 1973
ati we nema mercenaries. Now we have mercenaries kill me today, tonight.
But without umvuke, now you have even more evidence that you are dealing with a rogue state, but still we're not doing anything. You Swazis, not progressive. You Swazis at the time.
No. I totally agree. With it's in a Maswati, mina nje sengiyayenge ithi it serves us right.
Yeah.
Naloko kuthi beba kakhulu le mali, it serves us right.
Yeah.
Because we are the ones who have given them an open ticket.
Exactly.
We should have stayed home.
Because mina, what I struggle with Nababendlangamandla is this. If you cannot go to the streets, and protest, join a party, join a civil movement and do something, the least that is being expected of you is to hold back your power.
Yes.
Boycott, sit at home, no one will ever do anything. Yeah. But Swazis are actively participating in the institutions, in the structures, in the events of the establishment.
But you must also not, you must also be analytic.
Okay.
What are the factors? 60% of the people are poor. So these people, now we tell a good at least I will get a meal there. At least I'm going out. Gas and clear the car, everyone. Sabula na COVID test, that's a car. The middle class, but opportunities. Because you can't even get a promotion if you're not pro-establishment. So if you're going to be a rebel, you're not going to progress in life. So people are just timing. We had to see nangakayile, I won't be recognized. I won't get into the second layer ladder in government. So okay, utawutsini ke wena utawusila bantu buyer willingly. No, they are coerced into doing what they are doing because it's a survival. It's a survival mode for everybody. If you can't act, you can't progress. These are some of the things that people
they mitigate. It's interesting that you kuluma ngalenza baye nangini, and I'm gonna just make this as a comment, then you can say what do you say about that. One of the failures of post 2021 for me is that it exposed that organizational development yet is not up to that level, because it's one thing to shout at the system, but it's another to have the institutional machinery that is rooted on the ground internationally, in civil society, in everywhere, as an institutional as an institution that can challenge the state. We now know on the evidence of history, Weguti, you do not successfully challenge a government merely by insulting it. You need to have the capacity, the finances, the networks, the organizational machinery that you unlock and it actions. So post 2021 taught us that organizations were not ready. We were not ready in civil society. Look at the trade union, for example. I don't think it sufficiently played enough role. Political parties eventually fought amongst themselves and really led Nemaswati Lebeganga observers. Agcina asekaba demotivated. I'm not even using the right word. And I want you to make a comment around this, because you've lived and seen the growth and otherwise of civil society. Nguphi la sisweak khona as civil society, and nguphi futhi la singastrengthisha khona, so that the fight for change goes beyond just ukuthuka uhulumende on social media or go make threats to the government that are not backed up by a solid organization on the ground.
I totally agree with you that we face organizational development challenges on a serious note. I look at my own sector, the NGO sector. Since we have seen organizations come and go. Because my institutions are quite mal, fundamentally. Our kiwa passion. Our kiwa njigogutsi kunebantu laba tanzako. It's, do you have backers? So the minaga I've seen Kango at the lowest end of scale, and at least in terms of its own development trajectory. Ngimbonile kutsi nayo organization ngayibona kutsi le machinery lena say ya maturisha because at any given time, once we mobilize the resources, we could send NGOs on the ground. And they do fantastic work on budget dialogues, on poverty dialogues, on many other issues, on human rights, mobilizing communities. And once we have got a machinery that works, and we've got capacity, we've got money, you can do anything. And then, as you say, you face now a declining, because remember, post 2021, government was on the drive yeku demonize non-governmental organizations. Some elements in government, they were saying these are the people that are causing unrest. Bokango who are causing unrest in this country. Unfortunately, Sapelo Arti Mlungwe Bandu Nil was in my own Sichekile Tina. There's nothing untoward that is being done by Kango and other NGOs. They do what they do best, which is mobilizing communities and going to the ground. And some city will mend it in even to mop up with all the mess of killing people. Ish. And all that. We had to mop up and bury people who were paupers. I mean, were very poor and could not afford. But they're still human beings. They deserved a dignified burial. So, and then you have got, on the other hand, we have got the NGOs as a sector. We have got the church. This sondo, at most, they're driven by money now. We could see get offerings and all. We don't have very likely
with social justice.
Issues of social justice in the church. Because for me, post 2021, it was the great opportunity. That was what I was preaching in my church.
Yes.
That the greatest opportunity to serve Maswati, but Bonel Sondo. That's why I believe the South African ANC, PAC, and all the other movements that were on the ground, they revere their church because it was the church that did the dead job. That was providing shelter, that was giving the money to go to school, go for training, and all that. Not our church. We're absent. As
I
a
agree,
church.
100%.
So, what is church? You have got Council of Churches, we have got Conference of Churches, we have got League of Churches, League Yagangwane, Council of Churches, Nayo decided to take a neutral role, whether it was good or bad, they will judge themselves. And then the Conference of Churches, Sinangala, I'm part of the Conference of Churches, Sihlabelingo Magutsi, Sikonda Ekaya and Tinina, Sina Sipegele Zulwini, Owalam Slabeni really is neither here nor there.
And I do admit, I am also very unhappy with the church. I don't think the church aiga bandishi bamvula bashonelwe.
No.
Ali
no,
aniga ngoba
no,
even when is
no,
political parties
no,
and civil society
no,
we're fighting. We
no.
thought the church will come and
yes,
harmonize us.
Yes.
Ngoba bona they are neutral. They could call us together and find each other. They never did.
No. Because they've taken sides. They've taken sides. Ngiyeke nje aye baye openly base ngiyothandaza kamthandeni. Ngiyothandaza kabaqede. Ngiyothandaza kagawuzela. Ngiyothandaza kakhomanda. Ngeke baze bakwente lokho ukuthi siyothandaza so let umthandazo. Because the people that are there, they still need prayer. They still need God. They still need to see ivangeli laNkulunkulu lelisinzisako nalelento umuntu abe sound emqondweni wakhe noma ngabe uhlupheke kangakanani. They still need that. And those children, they need umase when all is said and done. But that babo se basafari shekangako, they need to say we saw God. Kepha kute, the church is absent.
But even nala masunve naboke, never mind the girl lena mine, I would have thought my church will say, hey, siyayiqala emvule yendekile la kangwane. It was the first time siyibona. Ngicela sithandazele live in the church and pray for the country, not the rulers. Pray for the country, pray for peace, pray for sanity. The church was never doing that.
This is the story of our lives. And then we have got the trade union movement. Now it faces its own challenges. Because uma kukhulunywa unemployment at this rate, kukhuluma ngema job losses, who is affected?
The trade union,
It is their people. It is the ordinary members. Once they have got dwindling members, it means the dwindling capacity. Trade union movement. So all this, and kulumeke ngama political parties, because they are totally excluded. They're not supposed to survive and at all. Labo ke structurally utawakha ngani imachinery that works.
But also when where will you get the people who phela bangabantu wesaba vele nangabe you've banned the political parties.
Yes.
So they have to work with what they have.
Yes.
And if what they have is extremely weak, they will have to make
no but even if Jesus khombisa kutsi you can have 12 disciples but you can transform society.
Oh, that's true.
Not society, the world.
The world, that's true.
12 people. but you can transform. So there's more to it.
That's true.
So in all the facets of society, it's broken because of the divisive nature of our society.
That's true.
The individualism of our society.
That's true.
So yonke lento lena nekokuthi ke we don't have friends. We don't have friends. We don't have donors, serious donors with serious money who can put money at the table and say, build your capacity, guys. Go and mobilize society. Go and empower communities and so forth and so on. So, logo kumende uhulumende waba on the pedestal. Waba on the winning side. Because lagithi structurally vele siyakula.
But why are we whining as civil society? All the time siya complaina, we don't have donors, we are repressed, we are beaten, we are, you know, the whining and crying.
Why not? We need to cry.
Yeah, but why is it called a struggle then if not that you have to overcome exactly that? That civil society should be able to woo a donor community.
That's why my brother, it took ANC over 100 years.
But it took MTC very late. Remember, MTC, by 2000 already...
No, the conditions for them were different.
Yeah.
The conditions for MTC was different. Remember that they were trade unions. That were converting themselves and getting into politics in a very hard way, in a very a difficult environment. But they were supported by white people. They were supported because the powers that be were interested in change in Zimbabwe.
That's true.
But no also, one is interested in us.
But I do sense a bit, and I mean this is I'm saying this constructively, that isn't it not time as civil society we see this, you know. I like what Steve Biko did. He said, guys, we are on our own.
Yeah.
Black men are on our own.
Yeah.
Shifted the mentality to say, we're not entitled for some donor in Britain to come and help us. We must fund our own revolution. We must fight as if no one cares about us. But I get a sense from civil society, and this was my concern even for years. There was a time in 2012, Hulumende uyeta uta uvela ithukoso, spending ithukoso. He comes kune mete, he comes uvela ithukoso ayivala. And the leaders of the time, they say, yeah, bayeke isto bakceba ailo. And I was like, why, what's this mentality of kceba? You know, why can't you mobilize the Swazis to fight back? Guys, no one is going to help us. We are on our own. We must fight back.
It is very difficult to mobilize the society. I really want to admit that it is difficult. For example, the teachers may say we are 10,000. SNAT may say we have 10,000 members.
Yeah.
But how many of those members are progressives?
Hey!
How many of those members can their boots can be on the ground?
That's true.
When it is hot.
That's very, very true.
We have not managed, because even the trade unions themselves, take for example those who are trade unions for MFM, there are many people there, but now ngatsike manje translate that into boots on the ground. Maswati ke lapho asahlele ekhaya ke lapho ayabukela. So I don't know. Maybe we need our I don't know what.
Let me tell you what is interesting. You say that. Do you notice ukuthi eMaswati uma ngabe kune march la mbabane manzini wherever eMaswati, they peep through the windows and watch as if niya perform,
yes,
performative.
Yes.
They are not seeing themselves as they should be part of that. And it always made me wonder, Emaswati, do they understand what they need to do for change?
No. Njengoba ngisho mina ngithi, we think individually. As you ponder ekhaya, ucabanga ukuthi nangiyale ngidawulimala. Futhi, what will I change? Kukhona nokuba dismissive. What can I change nje? Ngikuthi nje ngisestaladini namuhla. We forget to learn from what the Senegalese have done. Just recently.
Yes.
The Senegalese, they took their leaders to prison. But what did they do? Those young men, they said, we rather die on the streets. Baba keep it 10, 15 days, 20 days before my elections. They won. They're running a government today.
No,
because that nation, country, those people understand, change It needs us, the boots on the ground.
I'm happy with that example because we saw it in Burkina Faso. The young people stood up on the streets. Because mina my critique when I went to Ndlangamandla, and I was talking to someone, there are two things that I think in the progressive camp needs to be done differently. One is to theorize. The social struggle is under-theorized.
Yeah.
It's under-theorized, and it needs to be theorized properly so that we understand what's the problem. What are the ticking points if you want to really touch the nerve center of the society? The second thing that I also think in is that the struggle also needs a complete paradigm shift, what I call the Shaka moment. Shaka Zulu, remember when he was building he said, look, we must cut our spears, which was a complete change in paradigm shift in terms of how they prosecute the wars in the Mfecane wars. And we must now attack the enemy from the horns and all of that. So perhaps in the civil society, we do need to rethink to touch the nerve center of Swazi society.
But who are these people who are supposed to think differently?
All of us. Me and you, we have to theorize anew the Swazi struggle and be able to look at the lessons of the past 30, 40 years and be able to say, if Banvu, after Babulewe, after Babonile, what has this government done? If they have been rechanged, they've lost jobs, they have seen the mess this country is. Now the recent Swazi leaks have shown this country is a heaven for money laundering, for worse criminal activities. But Swazis are not as
going to
up
be moved.
In arms
or
moved.
No.
So therefore, we do need to therefore rethink this society. And I guess it's a challenge I'm throwing to the MSF since you are there as well. But see, let's re-theorize this struggle and perhaps enter the Shaka Zulu movement.
I believe you're right. Because if you don't understand people, I was talking with another comrade the other time, and he says change has never been brought by a majority. It's maybe 20% of society that can bring change. I'm struggling to understand his theory. Unless we have got arms. But if you are going to mobilize society, I think about Martin Luther, facing those giants, facing, you know, the tide, against them, but they were able to
overcome.
At some point, they were able to mobilize but 1 million men. So I think I agree, totally agree with you. We must analyze this society.
Yeah.
We would see what makes this society tick.
Yeah, exactly.
And what is it that we need to do and work from the ground?
Yeah, agree.
Just like my organizations like Bo Muslim Brotherhood.
Yes.
Because those organizations, when they emerge, they immerse themselves in the people.
Yes.
And then started to build from the ground.
Yes.
I worked in 2000 when I joined Kango. We started a program called Mchumanisi. It was a public hearing about poverty.
Okay.
And I will go there armed with a pen and a flip chart. Pen and a, to listen to communities.
Oh, yes.
I just went there and said, what, you know, when you analyze, what is your problem? What role is being played by NGOs? What role is being played by government? What is role being played by... They laid everything bare. I remember it was... the voices and everything else. And nasibuya le siyabhala lapha ukuthi sifike community lethi they yathi sasi bese sipublisha nakulo sasithi people's issues document. Sasi ayithatha ke manje siyisa Minister of Education, these are your issues. Minister of Health, these are your issues. Agriculture, this is what people are saying. We need a groundswell, a movement that will start from the ground. And I believe when government stops Kango at some point during the Nagwakui Constitution, bangafuni kusisende. I said no. We need to have labantu bala ku community. Yeah. They must be the ones who organize.
Yes, yes.
Sina singafika nje sesiya imeja into that. But we can't come from Babane so organize abantu base shiselweni
one. I like that. I really love what you've just said. It also means in the civil society we must also go on a listening campaign.
Oh, yes.
To listen,
oh, yes.
To listen, yes. So we don't come, because what we come and tell people thinking atabuguti, but in a part, and you need to come from start from their problems,
yes.
Upwards,
yes.
The issues of emandi,
yes.
Civil service delivery,
yes.
Poverty,
yes.
And then be able to package that,
yeah.
Up. And how does it link to the political system?
No. We definitely have to work like that, because when you come top down and you're ideological about you believe in this ideology or that you want to indoctrinate people don't listen to you.
Mm.
But when you come and listen to the people, because for me, when I was doing my analysis of poverty, it was spectacular. I will never forget that period, because I was riding the cry. I was so happy,
yes.
Excited, and I used to get comments. There was some top government officials, but say we are not that sega no coordinator wako we na director lapo no coordinator wakang we are not that sega and media bopes they used to like, you know, those voices
that's from the crowd, yes.
ba wakusaga te jengo ba kunjado ebona it was still the space was still very much
open
at the time. So vele labantu, they know the issues.
Yes.
When you come to governance, ngoba nana yongang sase analyze that thing.
Okay.
So how are you governed?
Okay.
The traditional authority on in passenger. Since siyofika esingengongwaneni. Sibuka la layers ukuthi from community, from bandlancane wakho
kuya
enduneni, kuya enduneni yebucopho, enduneni yemcuba, usekuya kula ma politicians. That's why ema MPs at that time they never liked me, because sasifike siba expose leke ukuthi kude laba kwendaba.
Actually, you were the more dangerous people, because
of
you
course.
Were at the heart of course.
Of, of course. The FIT, I will never forget, because that money, it really transformed Kango from this shell where we were before to a dynamic organization that was mobilizing cinema society. Going forward, some meetings were even patronized by ministers.
That's
Minister of Finance will come to listen before I went to budget speech. Will come.
We must compete
and get views. Atayele parliament nje armed ngema views of the people.
You know, Mr. Ndlangamandla, I'm happy that you are bringing to the MSF that kind of thinking and that kind of dynamism and experience. Ngiyethemba ukuthi we will come back as civil society different from the post 2021 failures.
No, but this is the most, for me, since ngaba active as an active citizen, I have never seen witnessed a difficult period like this one.
No, that's true.
This is the most difficult period for all of us as organizations, as individuals, as activists. We are born anyalo. Awat ukuthi uphuma ubheka
phi. That thing, ngicela nje ukuphosisa lapho. I want to throw a challenge to you. Bantu bathite basesekhungethwe letimvo letendekela vele. And then we in civil society started to fight. In particular political parties. We fought on the basis of political direction, political philosophy, ideologies, and strategies.
And
it created a lot of confusion and disappointment in Banff. So when people see Bambula Banjengani, Babendlangamandla, who can be listened to by everyone, by government, by political party A, political party B, civil society A, civil society B. Iko na ini I role loibona kungazuthi nini as elders now. You are going to play to harmonize and recalibrate labanvu who are now at loggerheads in the progressive camp. And yini lecabanga ukuthi kungendeka to put these feuding organizations, personalities into the table so that they can come back stronger in fighting for change.
Yenqamala. these people have taken hardline positions.
Yeah, ne.
You see, when people are fixed in their positions,
yeah,
very difficult to navigate that.
Mm.
Very difficult to navigate that. Unfortunately, they are playing. They have played into the hands of the enemy in the sense that what Sopuza said about parties in 1973 that they are divisive, they have shown it.
Ish.
They laid it bare. We would say, I don't take it as a divisive. I take it to could see very multi parties and noisy business.
Means exactly that.
Multi parties noisy. Mina ngutsathi ukuthi is a negative logo ukuthi bantu banema positions la hard lanjani njani. Because I understand ukuthi ka multi party vele ku noisy. Ngala kunendoda lephethe sagile. Ushaya yona kuphela. So ke vele ku quiet ngala. Ngala vele kutaba nale but also as a society phela we is evolutionary. Siyafunza nathi as a society we are now trying to understand nale issue nje yebuphathi is a new thing angithi nje boswalimo bafike post 2021 ngeke bese sisho ukuthi sesingaba very hard to everyone ukuthi vele as we emerge kepha kakhulu lokusente mina lengubuka ukuthi kube idownside yethu thina njengebantu siya personalize into. If I hate Mancoba, I hate him. It's neither here nor there. Once I hate you, I hate you. So for now, we want to be to assemble think tanks. Because we owe this country, we owe this country all our intellectual and emotional contributions. Leave. I have nothing to lose now. No mga ngise chele, no mga ngbulala, vele seng sonzele kufene anyway. So okay, I have nothing to lose, really. Seng bakulisile bandwa na kunjanja. So I think we just need to focus kukuthi singenda anitina because I don't view, personally, I have never viewed kukuthi a ban is an enemy or what. We have differences of opinion. Whether we are a Mangololo, whether we are this side or that side. Singaba nema differences of opinion. But we have this country to run. Sinana the country, the only country we have. So all of us, we need to find my solutions. Laya embed instead of bickering, fighting each other, and all that.
Yeah. I want to come back to the issue of a massive society. Ngifuna nje ukunika diagnosis yakho le overboard without being specific. I mean, I've seen in civil society organizations come and go. I remember there used to be a very important organization before it came back, Women in the Law, and then it began to hog headlines for all the bad reasons about accountability, corruption, maladministration, and all of that. And the name organizations, they were doing a beautiful work. Buyongenawe coalition, know better. Yeah, but those organizations have died today, partly because of funding, I would imagine, partly because of many other things. But yini lokubone wena ku contribute kakhulu ekufeni noma kumbe ku lack of bese akasabi the same sting lama organizations from your experience nje kwakhanga.
My experience, I believe in organizational development very strongly because once lama structures a organization are fractured, you will see these tendencies.
Yeah,
you must have a strong board.
Okay,
a board that appreciates its role as an oversight institution. Then you must have your professional staff, labalaba ranisha lomsebenzi, who are extremely accountable kule board.
Okay,
that organization must be driven by a strategy, strategic plan,
and
then once we are set up at the institutional, the fabric of the institution, then you must be home and dry because let's look at my organization. Either law director becomes too big, agasisi accountable. Nale port is sebandwa bakhe.
The founder syndrome. I've also heard something called the founder syndrome.
Ukhanze umuntu ahlele port ni for 15, 20, 30 years. Selo nguye njenga lenye organization lengiyati ngicishe ngashona ligama lapho kuna chairman munye lengimatiko mina seloke yavela so ke once you have those issues of governance aku ibhodi ayisiclear ayiwenti umsebenzi wayo ayihlangani both must meet at least every quarter that is in my template.
But isn't that not what is driving the donors away? Ngoba bese siyasola sithi why are donors not supporting Swazi civil society and political groupings? But they can give you evidence ukuthi hey at the APNC sifaka imali lapha, we didn't get value for money.
No, but in the scale of things I don't think I'll say Swazi organizations are bad.
Okay.
We have really shown those tendencies.
They
are bad situations. Post nagufakwe imali lebo Zimbabwe kuphi. Lots of things emerged. Leti imbi nge civil society.
Yeah.
Because people can be bad. Regardless who's back with people back civil society or in government. We can be as corrupt.
I mean, corrupt the church. Yes. How much more than that ordinary people?
No, so the mass situation is not really about kwekutsi kuphele imali per se. Kufela ama structures in organizations of accountability. Mina in my personal career, lengifike ngaku-understanda kahle kwekutsi nguwe wena leader that needs to live an ethical life. Highly ethical individual. Ngoba ema systems people they break systems. Ngoba ungambribe na finance manager wakho ni bribe ane nithi asidlele imali. If you like. So ke those are the problems that needs to be ema boards. Once I'm in a board, mina as an individual I'm a serious person. Angeke ngene boardini uthi uto bese ungenda umfana wakho. Noma umuntu nje lo tamsebenzisa, no, I can't accept that. So board members must know their role. So kuthi silapha for oversight. Silapha want to set up policies, want to make sure kuthi a director went umsebenzi wakhe, want to make sure kuthi siyamsupporta as much as possible. Ngoba naloko kuthi ni se board nisendwa na director, you are competing for what? Because in net terrain, no longer you must run your race.
That's true. In an organization. And then I want to talk a bit while Sesiangasima Petele and Ndlangamandla about the MSF. You took that role there, and the MSF, as you are saying, is struggling like all of us to come back into. I mean, ngeke ngiyimajore njenga any other thing ngoba phela bokuthi MSF before 2021. But what are the difficulties and the challenges and the opportunities that are coming up with MSF to make it to be a ticking organization? And I'm saying this cognizant of the fact you are really merely a coordinating center. What really makes the MSF are the individual organizations laga pa?
So we have said so.
Yeah.
Because we are as strong as your members.
That's true.
If your members are weak, there's no apex body that can run and be strong. It can't work like that. So, MSF, mbamba, lo kufike kwasi Kenya beta kakhulu, are these issues of elections.
Ish!
Lenza by my elections and the positions thereof labesa ya tatwa lapo a creator the wage now kukuti kuna bobani ngala kuna bobani ngala. I think that was our first biggest challenge post 2021. Of course change of leadership sasikala na tulane saketwa nga December tulane January is dead. How to explain that? So before he even assembled the team, you hit the head, basho njalo, bese the team vitenda njani, they scatter. So to try and reconfigure, he is banned from the country.
Ish.
He can't come here. So these are structural issues that are big that we need to navigate ekwekuthi sikwenta kanjani, and then we have these fragmented organizations now that were active lamanye asaseceleni because of
the wage
because of the wage kutsi bona bathathe a certain stance labanye bathatha a certain stance. So we are a divided lot, but more importantly, if you have been hearing bo prime minister these days abafuni nje kuva nge MSF nabahlangana na Facebook basithe phuma ka MSF, it's not the first time coalitions like MSF find themselves in a quagmire. When we set up coalition, it was the same. Prime Minister of the time was the Federation of Business at the time come out of it. Ngisibomandla, they had joined hands with us at the time. So kwathiwa phumani. Nyaloke vele ke kude nje ebudlelwane longabuthola
but beninhlanhla ke
yathathwa belumbi.
I remember very well actually the leadership you played in coalition when I mean maybe it also talks to the quality of leadership at the time. I think even in a society of a civil society you must put a mirror. Because you were able to fight the pressures both from government and political parties. Remember they were not allowed to join coalitions. And I remember there was a lot of critique against coalition and all of that, but you were able to shield it, but also shield it from the government. I mean, if you look at the leadership, lebe ikona lapho bobo besithole wengcongwane yourself, babehlatshwa bobo Musa Hlophe. It was a very solid leadership.
Very solid. Uma ubuka la apex bodies, how strong and cohesive they were. Very, very solid.
But also, we must not be too hard on the MSF and the current leadership. It out image appeal with time and be strong.
We don't have the time. I don't want to mince words there. We don't have the time. This country now lama leaks nje akhuluma kona ukuthi le live siyawukhanza one day lingekho. The auctioned and sold. Kutsiwe nje kuthi Swaziland yathengiswa.
Eish,
sile angekhazi. So it needs ground soldiers that are going to go on the ground. Sikhulumisane sisive ngoba le ndzaba ye dialogue thina ka MSF sakholelwa kuye ukuthi the only way out. That's why even as they bomb each other Gaza, they still have dialogue by Egypt baya kuphi kuphi, because kude lo yakwenta phande we dialogue. A serious one, not spy. But a serious one.
But don't you think ukuthi now talking dialogue would really well benefit hulumeni angayibithi dialogue when civil society is not this strong, kungaba to the advantage of government. So maybe it's time kwekuthi mhlawumbe while civil society reorganizes and recalibrates angathi ngayibeka kanjani, but ngikwazi ukuthi if government were to be happening now, we would lose almost
everything. No. I'm not sure. Government is, that's why government is still uncomfortable to call a proper dialogue.
Okay.
Agati, for example, nangasi nje namhla bahlele nabangathi singayisukela referendum and win. Abati, they are not certain.
Yeah.
Because awati labantu nasebanikwe right information ukuthi what will they do in the ballot box.
In fact, it's not just that SARSs are not quiet. They are peaceful, or they are not silent.
No,
they are being forced.
Yes,
so therefore it's difficult.
That is why they have run away from dialogue. They've run away from dialogue.
Yeah,
because logo the public hearings they assess by any, they are not dialogue. They're just public hearings ukuthi imaswata akhone ukuthi hamla akhulumela la khulumako, but dialogue is a serious business of give and take. What is happening in Gaza kuswe nihle nehlulwana nehlulwa nje le sentence ukuthi asivumelana nale sentence na hambane abuyelana eKhatha abuyelana eGibhithe niyothatha imandate uthi leli gama leli sitshintsha njani.
But my last one, Baba Ndlangamandla, it's been a very beautiful, nuanced conversation, but I would like to ask, someone is at home today and is watching you in your capacity as MSF, also in your leadership as an elder in the struggle. How should we hope for meaningful dialogue within civil society, within the fielding parties, within the leading players in the progressive camp. Are we going to be seeing mature leadership dialogue within each other and easing of hostilities towards the united front in the progressives themselves?
We have no choice but to find each other.
Yeah.
That's not a choice. I don't think we have a choice. We just have to find each other as progressives. And because if we don't do that, we remain fragmented. It translates to the community.
That's true.
Community will not look at us as a viable alternative if we continue this fragmentation that they see. So I think our role as MSF is to be what we call a Sakema bridge.
Yes.
Let's try to really create platforms where you can find each other.
Last one, Ndlamandla, I've just remembered. There is a critique that one writer, Yaka the Bridge, wrote that it seems that there are too many cooks in the Nang. When do I in the good civil society all the time? Coalition, SUTF, MSF. Now, Namina saying unhappy MSF, saying Pumile, Nakasega. How do you see, how can you undermine that?
The problems, Nasa Kaletindo, Sitreka ideology into it. I think for me, as an individual who is not ideological, I'm not ideological. I'm just a progressive. I'm an activist. So sometimes, I've learned at least at the Kango space. Kango is as diverse. Who corner la public fund they could see in Tlanga no ige sluga ne corn. But I will have a way as a leader. Sometimes in yatsele tindo leng tibona go kutsi ngemabibi ke manje la. Sometimes there were times when I would say to an organization, when I guess I'll puma when I'm about partali membership or anything, but I'll keep quiet. Because for me, membership was important. Numbers mattered. So sometimes we'll disagree on LGBTI issues. But we will have to find a way. We would say, how do we accommodate each other until bantu baze bagcine bathi ukuthi LGBT are actually human beings.
But isn't that what is missing in civil society? That is where Tineba Ndlangamandla sibuke bamvula banjengani to be able to bring us together, sitawukhulumisana, sitawufind each other. Because what is happening in the progressive camp right now is much more ego driven lama differences. They are really not much.
No, no, no.
Nalo kutu uye parliament or not shouldn't make you eternal enemies.
No, no, no,
you can't even work together.
No.
So maybe the challenge is on people like yourself to use the space in the MSF to bring civil society together and to dialogue within an MSF.
As I have said, as in our choice, we just need to do that. If we fail there, we fail to unite, then the status quo will continue in
That's
the foreseeable
true.
Future until we reach 100 years.
And the country will collapse.
We hope God will save it from total collapse. But the way it is going,
I'm
not optimistic.
Yeah, no, thank you so much. Thanks, really, really appreciate it. Beautiful conversations.
Thanks.